What's up, guys? Welcome back to Streetball Strategies. Today we're talking about how to start your basketball legacy in 3 steps.
In due time, just one try to get it right. Bright lights hit your eyes, it's showtime. Let's go, make sure they know who you is when you're walking through the door. Train to go.
So I've talked about the first 2 steps before, I just never indicated them as being actual steps. So I'm gonna breeze through the first 2 steps and then emphasize this video on the last and third step. So the first step on how to start your basketball legacy in 3 steps is to respect the game. Respecting the game is always head and shoulders number one before anything else all the time. We play basketball because we love the game, and we come out here to the park especially and grind and work all day every day because we love the game. There is no fans, there is no paycheck, there is no championship to win. It's just because we love the game. And if we love the game that much to put in that much work, then we should be respectful of the game as well. And the ultimate way to pay respect to the game is by giving the game our full effort every time we're out here. And that doesn't mean just physically playing ball out here. That also means mentally and studying the game, and emotionally when making sure that we are always connected emotionally to the game. The second step in how to start your basketball legacy is to win, to build a winning culture that revolves around you and your game and your presence out here. Remember, we're trying to build a reputation, we're trying to build a legacy, and the basis of that legacy is that we are winners. When people think about us, when they see us, the first thing they think about is winner. When people are on our team, their chances of winning drastically increase, and when they are our opponents, their chances of winning drastically decrease. Winning is the very first thing we want associated with us when it comes to other people out here on the court. Now, forming and building that culture and that aura and that reputation of being a winner is going to take a long time. It's going to take a lot of effort, it's going to take a lot of experience, and that experience is going to come from a lot of losing, a lot of failure. But that's what makes being a winner so valuable. That's what makes that reputation and that aura so valuable, is that everybody knows that in order to get to that point, to have that reputation, you had to put in all kinds of work and all kinds of time. Because of that, because of the respect that comes from that, winning is the ultimate currency out here on the court. The third step in how to start your basketball legacy is something I haven't mentioned before, but I believe it to be pretty much as important as the first 2 steps. And that is that you should enhance everybody's experience. So because this is a new principle that I'm introducing, I always like to explain the what, why, and how of the new concept. So what I'm talking about when I say enhance everybody's experience is that you want to have people have the thought, the feeling, the aura about you that when you approach the court, when you come out here, everybody's experience gets better. They have a better time, they have a more enjoyable time, simply because you've shown up. When you show up to the court, people are going to have the thought and the idea and the feeling that now their experience out here is going to improve noticeably, simply because you decided to come out here and spend time with them. There's something specific and unique about you that you bring to the court that when you're out here, their experience with you makes playing basketball that much better and that much more enjoyable. Why this is important is because it's a win-win situation for everybody. So not only is their experience enhanced out here, so is yours, but also when you enhance one person's experience, they then spread the word to their friends that when you come out on the court, you specifically, because you're here, their basketball experience is about to increase and become more enjoyable because of your specific presence. And when you enhance one person's experience and they spread the word to other people, and then you let those other people then experience it for themselves, then they spread the word to their friends, and now your reputation is now spreading and building simply because you decided to enhance everybody's experience every time you come out here. And what's cool about how this is accomplished is that it's very personal. It's very unique to you and your own personality. So it's all about what you bring as an individual person out here to the court that enhances people's experience. And of course you want your on-court play to be part of what enhances people's experience out here, but it doesn't only have to be on the court play. It can be other things as well. Let me give you guys some examples of my own from my own past. Show 'em what they never saw. Time to show 'em. So back in the 90s, I used to be the neighborhood DJ, right? So anytime we'd have gatherings, I would play the music for those. The same thing took place with our Saturday game days out here at the park. We would be playing good basketball and listening to good music because I would bring my boombox out here with me, and that would enhance everybody's experience, and that was something that no one else besides myself was doing. Also, in general, my favorite activity of all time is to laugh and smile, and my favorite way to go about doing that is by making other people laugh and smile. And so when we're out here, as long as I'm respecting the game, as long as I'm doing everything I can to win, then why not have as much fun and joke around and make jokes and make fun of each other as much as we can, as long as everybody's enjoying themselves? I can be the butt of the joke all day long, as long as I'm respecting the game and doing everything I can do to try to win, as long as everybody's laughing and having a good time and everybody's experience is being enhanced, I don't care about being the butt of the joke. I don't care about making fun of myself. It's fine. As long as everybody's laughing and having a good time, that's something else that I brought to the court that was very specific to me and my personality that would enhance everybody else's experience. And in terms of on the court skill and play, well, I'm a pass first point guard. So when people would play with me, they would know and understand that not only were they going to be able to do the funnest part of the game, which is to score, but I was also skilled enough to get them good shots in great positions and perfect rhythm to get the shot that they wanted. So because I did this every time I was out here, people came to know and understand that when they were on my team, they would get to play like superstars. They would get to be the leading scorer. They would get to have all the fun. I would do all the hard work and they would get to win. So why wouldn't you want to be on my team? Why wouldn't your experience be enhanced when that's the kind of experience you have when you're on my team? So when you put those things together, the off the court stuff and the on the court stuff, people's experience gets enhanced exponentially, and I do that every time so that I build up that reputation of when I'm out here, people have a better time just because I'm here. So hopefully you can see and understand why enhancing everybody's experience benefits everybody out here. And when you take all three of those parts and put them together, now you have your recipe for how to start your basketball legacy in three steps. So if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button. That's what this channel is all about, this basketball philosophy and strategizing how to use this philosophy to help you succeed out here on the court. So if you like this kind of material and this kind of information, make sure you hit that subscribe button and that notification button. And I will see you guys next week. Time to show them who you are. Final chance to prove it all. Then I'll show them what they need.